Hi listeners, welcome to the video lecture series on power electronics. In this video, we are going to continue the remaining part of the buck boost converter design expressions. For further reading, you can follow this textbook on this corresponding page numbers. Next part of the derivation is to find out the switch current average and RMS value and diode current average and RMS value. So let us try to derive these two now. So the ninth part of the derivation is to find out the average and RMS value of the switch current. Whenever the switch is on, then only the current will be flowing through it. So we can look into the average current which is flowing through the switch. So when switch is on, we can see that whatever the current which is flowing through the switch, it is flowing through the inductor also. So this is the average value of the inductor current which flows through the switch. So this part will be there for the switch also, and from this part, since the switch is off, there will not be any current flowing through it. Again, from this point where the switch is on, again the same magnitude of current will be flowing. Again, from this point, it will come down. So this is going to be the final value till this point. So now I want to find out the average value of this waveform till this time period T. For me, let me take this rectangle area, and if I try to find out the rectangular area here, which is the switch average value of the switch is given by the height of this rectangle is IL average. So IL average into, if I look at the time period, that this breadth of this rectangle, it is dt, breadth of this rectangle is dt, whole divided by the time period of this entire wave is t, so which is equal to t. So this t and this t will get cancelled. So the switch average value is IL average, the average value of the inductor current into its duty cycle D. So this IL average is nothing but minus I naught divided by 1 minus D. You can substitute it and find out the IL average in terms of the load current also. Similarly, the switch RMS current, IS RMS, can be found out by just taking the square root of the above expression and squaring the inside values. That is IL average square into DT by T, into DT by T. So if I cancel this, I will get IL average into root of D. This is the expression for the RMS value of the switch current. Similarly, the next part of the derivation is, that is the 10th part, is to find out the RMS and average value of the current which is flowing through the diode. When I look into the diode will carry current only when the switch is in off condition, that is like this. So this is the duration where the diode carries current. If I look at the current through the inductor, is the current flowing through the diode also. So if I try to draw the waveform for the current through the diode, it will be looking something like this. Till this point, there will not be any current flowing through the diode. From this point, the current through the inductor and current through the diode both are same. So this will be the current which is flowing through the diode. So if I look at, this is the expected waveform, average value waveform of the current flowing through the diode. So when I try to calculate the area for this part, this is the part which I am trying to calculate the area. So ID average value of the diode current can be written as IL average into this duration. This duration is 1 minus D into T, 1 minus D into T whole divided by T. So if I try to simplify this, this T and this T will get cancelled. So it is left out with IL average into 1 minus D. So this is the expression for average value of the diode current. Similarly, average RMS value of the diode current can be found out by just multiplying, that taking the square root of IL average square into 1 minus D T whole divided by T. 1 minus D whole divided by T. So this T and this T will get cancelled. So it is left out with IL average into square root of 1 minus D. So this is the expression for diode current RMS value. So I am having four expressions now. This is expression number 11. This is expression number 12, and this is expression number 13, and this is expression number 14. So these four expressions are taken at this corner in order to make the further derivations so simple. All these four expressions has been included here, which we have derived recently. And now let us go into the next part of the derivation. In the next part, we are trying to derive the ripple in capacitor voltage, that is delta Vc, and the value at which that ripple is maximum, that is D at which the delta Vc is maximum. So let us try to derive these two expressions. Ripple in capacitor voltage can be calculated by considering the off state of the switch. So let us go into this state. When this state only the, sorry, by considering the on state of the switch, when this state only the capacitor is delivering the power to the load. So which means that the energy stored in the capacitor is now releasing its energy to the load. So the 11th part of the derivation, in order to calculate the delta Vc, I am considering the on state of the switch, and during this condition only the capacitor is releasing its energy into the load. So let us take into the current through the capacitor when it is in on condition, that is the second equation. So let me write the second equation here, that is Ic on is equal to minus I naught. Ic on is equal to minus I naught. This has been written by considering this node. KCL equation, if I try to write it at this node, because the current through the diode is equal to 0 because it is in off condition. So when I try to write KCL here, I will get this expression. So once I got this expression, I can write the capacitor current can be written as C into dVc by dt. C into dVc by dt, which is equal to minus I naught. So dVc can be written as minus I naught by C, minus I naught by C into dt. So if I integrate on both sides, then I will get integration of dVc is equals to minus I naught by C into integration of dt. So if you look at, this is happening only during the on time, and on time the capacitor is releasing its energy. So I want to consider the limits of the capacitance. Limits of the capacitance, in the sense it is discharging now because it is not connected to the source. So it discharges from maximum value to minimum value. So initial point of integration will start from maximum and it will end at minimum, and this happens during the on time of the switch. On time means 0 to dt. So this is happening from 0 to dt. If you look at this expression, is very similar to that of the expression what you derive for the boost converters concern. So integration of dVc is Vc, and I can put the limits as Vmax and V minimum. Limits of integration are Vmax and to V minimum minus I naught by C. Integration of dt is t, and the limits of integration are 0 to dt. If I substitute this, this becomes V minimum minus V maximum. V minimum minus V maximum is equals to minus I naught by C into dt minus 0. So that is becoming dt. And we know that delta Vc, that is the inductor voltage ripple, delta Vc can be written as V maximum minus V minimum. V maximum minus V minimum. But here I have V minimum minus V maximum. So this can be written as minus delta Vc, which is equal to minus I naught by C into dt. So from this expression, I can write delta Vc is equals to I naught by C into D, and this T can be written as, this T can be written as F. So let me clearly write it here. This C and this T can be written as F. So this is the expression for the ripple in the capacitor voltage. So this is the next expression, which is expression number 15. And the 12th part of the derivation is to find out at what value of D this delta Vc is maximum. If you look at, D is directly proportional to delta Vc. So we know the limits of D. Duty cycle can be varied from 0 to 1. So this delta Vc will be maximum only when D is equals to 1. So I can directly write. So D is equals to 1. This is the value of D at which the delta Vc is maximum. So this is the next expression, expression number 16. So let me write these two equations again in this summary list. Now the last part of the derivation is to calculate the critical inductance and critical capacitance. Let us derive these two. We know that critical capacitance is the value at which the inductor current becomes discontinuous. That is, IL minimum, I want to put IL minimum is equal to 0. If I put IL minimum is equal to 0, then that is the place where the inductance current becomes 0. IL minimum already we have derived, which is IL average minus I delta IL by 2, that is expression number 9. So let me rewrite it here, IL average minus delta IL by 2 is equals to 0. This is the IL minimum expression. So from this expression I can write IL average is equals to delta IL by 2. So if I try to simplify this, IL average is nothing but minus I naught divided by 1 minus D. So I can replace that here. So this can be written as minus I naught divided by 1 minus D, which is equal to delta IL by 2. Again, delta IL can be replaced by expression 7. So if I replace that, I will get minus I naught divided by 1 minus D is equals to delta IL is given by D into Vs divided by LF. You can just look into the expression number 7 into 1 by 2. If you assume that the load is of resistive in nature and the voltage across it is V naught and the current through that is I naught, then I can write I naught is equals to V naught by R by simply applying the Ohm's law. So use that option here. So I will get minus V naught by R into 1 minus D is equals to D into Vs by F into the critical value of inductance. So I put L subscript C and this 2. So this is the expression. Again, this V naught can be replaced by expression 5, which is given here. V naught is equals to minus Vs into D divided by 1 minus D. Use that option here. So this becomes D into Vs divided by R into 1 minus D is already here. One more 1 minus D is coming here. So 1 minus D whole square, which is equal to D into Vs divided by 2F into L subscript C. So if you look at this DVS and this DVS will get cancelled. So finally, I can write the critical value of inductance LC as, from this expression, I can write R into 1 minus D whole square whole divided by 2F. So this is the expression for critical value of the inductance to be used in the circuit in order to avoid the discontinuous conduction mode in the inductor current. So this is expression number 17. So let me take this expression and put it in this summary corner. The last part of the derivation is to find the critical value of the capacitance. In order to find the critical value of capacitance, put delta Vc minimum is equals to 0. Vc minimum is equals to 0. Just put Vc minimum is equals to 0. Vc minimum can be written as Vc minus delta Vc by 2 is equals to 0, which is very similar to that of the capacitance inductance current. So from this I can write Vc is nothing but V naught, both are in parallel. So Vc is nothing but V naught. I can bring this side, so this becomes delta Vc by 2. And delta Vc already we have derived and it is given in expression 15. So use this expression 15 here. So V naught is equals to 1 by 2 into delta Vc is D into I naught by Cf, C into F. So this is delta V, delta Vc. So from this expression I can just V naught, I naught can be written as V naught by R, considering that the load is of a resistive in nature. So I can rewrite this expression as V naught is equals to 1 by 2 into D into I naught, can be written as V naught by R into 1 by F into the expression for capacitance critical value. So I put C subscript C. So if I look at D into this, I can further write it as D 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 into D V naught divided by R F C C. C C in the sense it is critical capacitance. Now you can see that this V naught and this V naught will get cancelled. So once these two V naughts get cancelled, I can write the critical value of capacitance as D divided by 2FR. So this is the value of critical value of capacitance. Just take this here, this becomes CC, that is the critical value of capacitance becomes D divided by 2FR. So this is the expression number 18, which gains the equal importance to the other expressions. So this is what all about the design equations of a buck boost converter. With this, we have completed all the three types of converters, that is buck boost and buck boost converters. Thank you for your patient listening, and we will catch up with your new video in the next lecture. Thank you.